Hi, I'm Greg Ira. I'm the director of the UC California Naturalist Program, part of the UC Agriculture and Natural Resources Division. The California Naturalist Program is a program designed to teach individuals in the state of California about their environment and what they can do to protect it and steward it. And we offer two courses. One is the California Naturalist course, and the other one is the Climate Stewards course. This is a fairly new course, just opened in the last 2 years. This October, we held the 2022 statewide conference for the California Naturalist program. The conference is a convening of all of our community. And when I say our California Naturalist community, I'm talking about those individuals that have gone through our courses. We invite all of those alumni from those courses, as well as the instructors who teach the courses. That's our primary community or our audience. But we also get like-minded individuals who are interested in our courses, but may not have yet to have taken one of them. So we decided this year to go with the Grand Lebakan in Tahoe City. This was a venue that kind of fits our audience. It's a little bit campy, so it's a kind of a campy resort, if you will. Typically, when we identify a venue for one of our convenings, a couple of the things that we do right off the bat is we approach our local partner organizations. We also recognize that we are conducting these events on traditional lands of Native Americans in California. In this particular case, this was on Washoe tribal land, and we reached out to the Washoe community and worked with them from the very start of our planning. Our primary contact was Rihanna Jones.
Let people know who visited the Tahoe Basin that you know the Washoe Tribe is here. You are in Washishua Day, the Washoe people's homelands.
She was just fantastic. She helped us from the very start, identifying different things that we could highlight, offering to help us with a welcoming address, and identifying members of their community that might be interested in participating in the conference. And that included one of her colleagues, Mark Lara, who co-presented during the conference, a session with Rihanna. Also Herman Fillmore. Herman is the language and culture liaison or resource person for the Washoe Tribe of California and Nevada. He gave a special session in the evening about culture and language of the Washoe people. So the conference started with pre-conference workshops. This started Friday late afternoon. We had several different workshops where invited speakers or experts would conduct a hands-on workshop with some of our conference participants. These things included working with drones and understanding how they can be used in natural resource management, working with native cordage and how indigenous groups use that to produce resources like baskets and other things. Topics that looked at national environmental education programs like Project Learning Tree and Project WET. We also planned or conducted some what we called early bird or night owl activities. So before the conference started in the morning, we had early risers could get together with others and they did a kind of a bird watching tour. There was another one I think that looked at the native trees or the local trees of the region. And then we had other activities in the evening like campfire conversations and songs. We also had our opening speaker, Jennifer Norris, from the California Natural Resources Agency. She's a deputy secretary working on California's biodiversity. The next morning, we went into our full day sessions, concurrent sessions. We had a wide range of speakers. They included people like Don Hankins, who's a professor at Chico State University, talking about cultural burning practices. We had Brenda Kyle, who's one of our naturalists from Southern California, and she talks about indigenous plants, using the local names for those plants. Another thing that we did at the conference this year was what we called the Skillshare Marketplace. And this was an alternative poster session. So instead of standing by a poster and explaining what you've done, people would bring in something that they use in their work and they would describe how they used it. So they would share their skills with others through this method. So we understand in the California Naturalist Program that the threats that we're trying to address through our program, whether it's climate change or environmental degradation, These are threat multipliers. They exacerbate these existing stresses in our communities. These stresses might be poverty, or they may be social inequities. And if our program doesn't recognize this, we're missing a really important part of what it means to be active in your community.
When they talk to me in English, and then they talk to each other in Spanish, and I interject and say, hey, hablo español, they immediately get really excited and ask me every single question they've ever had about any state park or national park or any open public land. They just feel that comfort. And for me, that's what makes it worth it, is being able to have an opportunity to storytell to people who would normally not reach out to employees, not go into the visitor centers.
So we had a really diverse audience in our conference this year. I mean, we had young adults, older folks, retired. We had people from rural areas, from urban areas. We had people from the Valley, from the Sierra, from Southern California. It was a really good mix of our community as a whole. And this is something that we've been working on intentionally to broaden participation in our program. There are a lot of people out in the state of California that value what we're offering in this program. They recognize that taking a course and getting empowered to make a difference, not only in their own life, not only in their community, but in the state of California, is something worth doing. And we're seeing the numbers grow. And eventually, we hope that we get more and more people from throughout the state participating in the California Naturalist Program. What we're trying to do is say, after you've completed your course, don't stop there. Keep coming back for convenings, reunions, trail hikes, meetups, other activities, book clubs, and continue to engage your fellow naturalists and climate stewards in this process of learning and continuing to practice and engage what you've started when you became a naturalist.